Hello, my dear friends, this is your Sunny and welcome to my Study Smart for Success channel. Friends, today we are going to see data interpretation. Okay friends, why data interpretation friends? Because in data interpretation, quantitative aptitude, okay, questions, at least 2 to 3 questions are asking. Okay, and friends, it is near about 5 to 10 marks. Okay, so friends, it is better to come into the data interpretation. And also friends, before going to the data interpretation, I already covered each and every topic which are coming in data interpretation related. Okay, so friends, don't afraid and watch till the end of the video so that you will get conclusion and also tricks on how to do the data interpretation. Okay friends, and now friends, it is a part of SBI Clerk preparation also. So, I am covering SBI Clerk preparation, previous questions plus data interpretation parts. So, that both the things will be happen together. Okay, friends. And see, friends, I already told you data interpretation is a part 1 video. Okay. In this data interpretation, I will cover at least 5 to 6 parts of data interpretation and cover old questions which are asked in previous paper. Okay. So, that you will have a better understanding and better analyzing of which type of questions you will get expected in the next coming SBI Clerk. Okay, this SBI Clerk prelims 2018 part 13 friends, part of part 13. So friends, before anything to say, see friends, you should know some of the miscellaneous chapter to do this data interpretations. Okay friends, I already told you in my playlist. Okay, see what are all the miscellaneous problems friends. One is averages, second one is partnership or ratio. Okay, both are like together, and the third one is simple interest and compound interest, and fourth one is percentages. In percentages alone, I categorize those type frequently asked in data interpretation. That is age, what percent of y, age, what percent more or less y, and percentage change. Okay. And friends, I will give you a description link of my playlist of averages, ratio, and simple interest and compound interest and percentages also. See friends, you can also go to my playlist here. Okay. And you can search playlist. Yeah, you can search playlist or you can directly see. Okay. Averages. Where is the average friends? I will show you averages. Okay, see friends, averages, I already uploaded my playlist. So please go to the averages and same way partnership. Okay, and same way profit and loss and simple interest and compound interest. Okay, I'm telling you again and again, please see all these miscellaneous, to do our data interpretation. And friends, most important is averages and percentages. Okay, where is percentages friends? 1 minute. Yeah, percentages tricks. Okay, these percentage tricks you need to know, before doing data interpretation. Then only you will come to understand how you can easily and fastly do the question of data interpretation. Okay friends, I hope you understand now what is the importance of these miscellaneous. And that's why I have covered before data interpretation coming all these miscellaneous. Okay friends, now I will give a little bit introduction. Okay, not exactly the total interest. If I give total introduction of averages, ratio, simple interest, compound interest, then it will take hours of time. Understand? So why I am suggesting playlist, go to playlist, and see averages, partnership and simple interest and everything. And normally I will tell you friends, what is average? The sum of all numbers by number of numbers, right? That is I don't need to give a more explanation of averages, but friends, I have covered short tricks on averages in my playlist. Okay, go to playlist. And same way partnership and ratio, that is A is to B. Okay. And if A is to B, so and so some amount, like 4 is to 5 and total amount is 90 rupees, what is the A share? Then 4 by 5 into 90. Okay. Same way we have to do like that. Okay. same thing will be asked in data interpretation also, and same way simple and component interest. There are some types of interest based data interpretation questions will be asked in exams also. And same way friends, percentages, the most common factor and the most important in the data interpretation, data interpretation will be percentages. Why? Because friends, always at least two questions will be asked from the percentages of data interpretation. So friends, I will give little more extra introduction on percentages so that you will come to know very easily while seeing this video. See friends, they frequently ask A is what percent of Y. That means A, sir, not Y, A is what percent of B. Here also B, right friends. That means friends, see, A is what percent of B. What do you say? A is what percent of B? That means A by B into 100. This much you need to do. And same way friends, if for example, I tell any table DA will ask like 2009. I have got a money of 10,000 rupees. And same way 2010, I have got 9,000 rupees only. Then he will ask, what is the money got in 2010, what percent will related to 2009. So directly you can say 9,000 by that means previous year, the related year, and divided by 10,000 into 100. Same way you have to do like that. So what will be the formula friends? Whenever directly asking, if he is asking here 2009 and here you will be asked 2010, you directly 2010 related to 2009. Into 100%. This will be the formula for A is what percent of B. And same way, A is what percent more or less than B. That means friends, A minus B by B into 100. Friends, this you need to understand friends. It is not a difference, it is the minus. It is not different from minus, because if B is greater than A, you will get loss percentage. Minus percentage. If B is, B is less than A. If B is greater than A, you will get profit percentage or plus percentage. Understand friends? This is the difference. So you need to remember it will be A minus B by B. And same way, what is percentage change? The percentage change is, 1 minute friends, I have to get some little space. I will get some space. So what is percentage change friends? If I ask, if I say like over the year, see, there are frequently asked, over the years in questions like that. For example, I can say 2009, I got 100 marks, and 2010, I got 90 marks, 2011, I got 70 marks, and 2013 so and so 80 marks. So what you will ask, what is the percentage of over the years? Percentage change over the years. So over the years means you directly take this is the final value and this is the initial value. Friends, this is the initial value. So here what I say, final value and initial value. So you directly take a difference between final value and initial value divided by initial value into 100. Friends, I hope you understand now. In this there is always be positive only. That means either whichever it is greater, there is no, if it is initial value greater, no problem. Initial value minus final value. If it is final value greater, no problem. Final value minus initial value. Understand, friends? Same way you have to do the final value minus your initial value minus final value. Whatever it is a difference. The difference between this more or less than and percentage change will be E minus and this is difference. Okay. Okay friends. Please understand what is difference, what is the difference between difference and minus. Okay. And I hope friends, you know, now you come to know that how you can, do your data interpretation questions in percentages. One more time I will give you friends, what you will ask, one, A is what percent of B, that is A by B into 100, just, that means whichever is telling you later, okay, percentage of later, you need to give denominator and same way it will become denominator. And same A, A is what percent more or less than B, that means answer will be A minus B by B into 100. And same way, percentage change. That means, whichever year he is giving. Like, in also friends, like that questions he will ask. Okay. 2009 to 2010. Okay. What is the percentage change? He will ask. So, then what is the answer friend? 2010 minus 2009 divided by 2009. Into 100. These values replaced by the table given in the data. Okay. So friends, don't confuse. Okay. These two formulas you need to understand very quickly so that you know how to do the data interpretation. Now friends, one more thing. Okay. You need to know. Okay. How many types of data interpretation questions will be asked in our exams. Okay. That you need to know friends, that is I will give you, okay, data interpretation, data interpretation, okay, there are too many types, that is, okay, one is table DI, okay, table DI, and second one is line, okay, DI, and third one is, okay, graph DI, fourth one is pie DI, okay, and pie chart, okay, pie DI means pie chart, okay, don't confuse friends, and fifth one is, nowadays new is coming, paragraph DI, okay, but these many types of DI interpretation questions will be asked in our exams friends. So you need to learn each and every part of the DI of these types. Like now I will cover table DI in two parts, and line DI and graph DI and pie chart DI and paragraph DI. Okay friends, don't be afraid. I will tell you each and every step how to do. There is no rocket science in this. If you know our miscellaneous, what I told you, averages, percentages, SI and CI, and also ratios, you can complete this table DI and also score at least 10 marks, okay, in our exams within 3 to 4 minutes only. Okay, friends, 4 minutes only. So, friends, please be with me and watch entire video and we will go to the problem now. Okay, friends, now see, friends, as part of data interpretation part 1, we will see data interpretation of table DI now. See friends, what is asking, directly we will go to the problem number, okay, 1. Given below is the table that shows the number of books sold from 5 stores on 5 days, okay. That means he is saying number of books sold from 5 stores on 5 days. That means these are the stores and these are the days. Okay friends, and now study the table carefully and answer the question. See friends, always read this first part, otherwise you will get, okay, answer wrong. Okay, so take at least, okay, 5 seconds to 10 seconds and read the first para, otherwise you will get a wrong answer. Okay, now see friends, what is saying, there are 5 stores and 5 days. Now see friends, what he is asking, what is the ratio of the total number of books, okay, total number of books sold from store D on Sunday, Monday and Tuesday together to that sold from store E on Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday together. See friends, Here you need to know ratio. So see friends, here ratio came. So that's why I told you, please see each and every part of our miscellaneous. Okay, that's why. Okay, now see friends, what is asking? Store D Sunday, Monday and Tuesday. See friends, Sunday store D. Sorry friends, store D we need. Okay, store D Sunday here and Monday here and Tuesday here. Friends, I am saying you don't write down 68 74 78, just calculate in mind only by seeing the table, because you don't have any paper in your offline. It is not an offline exam, it is a online exam. You need to see computer and calculate. See how easy you can calculate, I will tell you. Okay, just see friends, there is a difference of, okay, it is near about 70's value. So directly take 70's. Okay, that means 70, 70, 70. Okay, 210 already is there. Okay, what is that? What is the difference between 70 and 68? Minus 2. Here minus 2. What is the difference between here? Here minus 2. Okay, and what is this one? Plus 4. Plus 4 and minus 2, remaining plus 2. And again 10, 8, 8 is the plus 8. So plus 8 plus 2, 10. So overall plus 10 equal to 220. That means store D will be the 220. Understand friends? And what is store E? We need store E. Okay, Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday. That means store E Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday. Right friends? Now answer, see friends, it is near about 85, right? So take 85, otherwise 90, you take 90, no problem. Okay, 90 90 90, how much? 270. It is exactly okay. It is minus 4. Okay, minus 4, minus 4, and here minus 6. So we need to minus 10. That is 260 will be the answer. So divided by 260 ratio. So 0 0 will cut 11 and 13. Answer will be 11:13. Understand friends how easy it is? See friends, don't confuse. Okay, once again I will tell you for your better understanding. He has asked, okay, store D, okay, Sunday plus Monday plus Tuesday. Okay, and store E Tuesday plus Wednesday plus Thursday together. And what is Sunday? Sunday amount is what? Is what is the Sunday amount friends? Here 68 plus 74 plus 78. And same way, what is here? 90 plus 86 plus 84. Okay, this will be together how much? This will be together 220, right? 220. And this will be together 260. So what he wants? Store D is to store E. Just take the values. 220 is to 260. 0 0 cut. 2 11s are 2 13s. Answer will be 11:13. Understand friends? But friends, don't do like this. I just, for your better understanding, I wrote down here like that. Otherwise, directly go to the DA table and add, and right away, okay, one step of ratio. That is 220 is to 260. Okay, 11:13. Understand friends, how you have to approach? Okay, now go to the problem number 2. We will see problem number 2. So friends, what is asking? Number of books sold on Friday from store C and D. Okay, increased by 15% and 20% respectively as compared to that sold on previous day. Okay, what number of books the store C and D sold on Friday? See friends, there is no Friday here, right? In table only Thursday. So what is asking? The Friday store C and D, the sales will be increased by 15% and 20%. That is, C is increased by 50% change plus, and D increased by plus 20% change. But how many you have to from previous day? What is the previous day? That is Thursday, right? So Thursday store D, how many has been sold? 40. So 40 already sold. So 15%, what is the 40 15% friends? 6, right? How you can check friends? See, 10% will be, 40% will be how much? 4. And what is the 5%? 2. So total overall 6. And 40 plus 6, how much friends? The resultant Friday Friday 46. And same way, what is the D on Thursday? 95, right? Thursday he has increased 95. So 95, what is the 20% of 95? What is 10% of 95? 9.5. What is 20% then? Into 2, yeah, again 9.5 add. 0, 1, 19 will be the 19%. So 19 here. And add both friends, 95 plus 19. 95, how much? 4. Okay, 1 will come here. 2, 9, 11. 1, 1, 11. Now you, what is selling? What number of books the store C and D sold on Friday? So just write down, friends. 46, 4, 50, 110. Means 160 will be the answer. See, friends, how easy it is. It is just matter of percentages now. See, you need to take 15% more and 20% more and write down the answer. Okay, friends, this way. And friends, I have to tell you, I forget that this question has been asked in, okay, 2nd December 2017 DA of IBPS clerks. Okay, friends. So, friends, don't neglect this question. These type of questions only will be asking nowadays for SBI clerk and IBPS clerk. So, friends, please remember, this is a previously asked question. It is not my own question for my better understanding and your better understanding. Okay, I'm taking the old question and understanding you, make you understand how important these type of questions are. Okay, and friends, I told you, after seeing this video, okay, I'm definitely telling you, you will get this answer within 2 minutes. Okay, 4 questions or 5 questions, whatever it is. Okay, friends. Now see, friends, problem number 3, we'll see. What is the number of books average? See, friends, here he has asked averages. Okay. What is the number of books, average number of books sold from store B on Sunday, C on Tuesday, and E on Thursday? That means we need to find out store B, store C, okay, and store E. And what days? Store B on Sunday. That means Sunday, and store C on Tuesday. Store C on Tuesday. And store E on Thursday, 84. Okay. These 3 we need to find out the average. See, friends, for your better understanding, I will write down here. Okay. But don't write store B each Sunday. How much? 89. Store C, 82. On when? Tuesday. Sorry. Okay. And same way, store E on Thursday is 84. Average we need. So directly addition and number of, okay, 89 plus 82 plus 84 by 3, right? So what will be the answer? See, friends, 80 80 80, already 240 is there. Okay, 240 plus how much it is extra? 9 plus 2 11, 11 plus 2 15. So 240 plus 15, 255 by 3. Answer will be 3 ones are 3 8 are 24 and 3 5 are. Answer will be 85. Average will be the 85. But friends, don't do like this. Okay, I will tell you how you have to approach. Just see the question and tell the answer. Okay, not by doing, okay, this thing. You know averages tricks also. Okay, you don't need to addition and apply addition and this thing. So see, can I say, friends, can I see the store B on Sunday? 89, 82, 80. So what is the nearest value? Nearest value, what is the, friends? 80 I can take. So directly take 80. And what is the what is the number higher than the 80? 9. So 9. You directly remember in mind 9. And what is here? 2. 9 plus 2, how much? 11. And what is here? 4. 11 plus 4, 15. So directly 15 divided by how many members are there? 1, 2, 3. So 3. 3 1s are 3 5s are. So 80 plus 5, 85. See, friends, in one step you have to complete this question. Okay. And also, friends, in mind, use mind. Okay. Understand, friends? I hope you understand how you have to approach. This is the right approach, friends. Okay. This is not, you know, this is a 3 number, so there is no much time, so I will do like that. But don't do like this, friends. Okay. In another questions, you will be asked, okay, 10 types of entries, okay, 10 types of entries, then what you will do? It is a better method, second method only better, okay. Now see friends, problem number 4. Total number of books sold from store B on Tuesday, that is store B on Tuesday, okay. See friends, I am directly rounding off Tuesday and Wednesday together, okay. Wednesday together are what percent more or less than the total number of sold from store C and D together on Monday. So, That means these two. So, friend, you need to find out, okay, store B, okay, Tuesday, okay, Wednesday. That is 55 plus 85. Same way, store C and D. Okay, right, he is saying store C and D. Store C and D, okay, on Monday he is asking. Okay, Monday, whatever, 36 plus 74. Okay, you need to find out what percentage more or less. Okay, I already told you in my, what is the percentage more or less? A minus B by B into 100. That I already told you, friend. So, here, what is the number, friends? 55 and 85. See, friends, 15 I will give you here. 60 plus 80, 140. And same way, what is the here amount, friends? 4 I will give you here. 40 plus 70, 110. What is the difference between, what is the A minus B, friends? 30. Okay, so 30 divided by, what is B value here? That is A here, brings down B here, 110. 0 by 1 into 100. 3 by 11 into 100, but that means 300 by 11. Answer will be 11 to 11 7 1 2773 by 11 percentage. Understand friends how easy it is? But friends, again I am telling you, don't do this all, okay. You have to do by here only. How? Just take the values here, see the values here in 55 and 85, you definitely know 140, right? And same with 36 and 74, 110. So 140 minus 110, that is 30 divided by 110, okay. Percentage change, 100, 0, 0 will cut, okay, sorry, okay, and 300 divided by 11, you get directly 27, 3 by 11 percentage will be answered. Understand friends, how easy it is? This type questions are asked in 2nd December 2017, friends. So, friends, please give importance to this type of questions, okay, don't neglect. Find the difference in total number of books sold from store C and E together on Tuesday. See friends, I will do directly from here. Okay, not I am not writing here. So what is saying? Store C and E. Okay, store C and E on Tuesday. Okay, Tuesday he wants, okay, difference. Okay, from first you need to find out what is the 82 and 90. Okay, 90, 80, how much was 170? 170 means 172 already taken. And same way, and from store B on Monday and Tuesday, Thursday together. Store B ka Monday 57 and Thursday 54. What is 57, 54? 50 plus 50, 100 plus 11, 1111. Okay, minus 1111. Answer will be 161 will be the answer. See friends, how easy it is? You just need to take the values and either addition, subtraction or ratio or average. That will be the question. Okay, I hope friends you understand very much well. Okay, if you like my video, please subscribe to my channel and also share to your friends so that they will also get benefited. Okay friends, we will meet in our next part of data interpretation, that is part 2. Okay friends, have a nice day. Bye bye.